In this lecture, I'm going to share with you what is a typecasting in Java, right? So typecasting is basically when you assign a value of primitive data type to another data type. So there are two types of typecasting, that is widening casting, that is automatically done by the Java compiler, and the next is narrowing casting, that is generated by the user, right? So I will show you the examples of these two also in the next lecture, but first of all, let's see what is the syntax for typecasting, right? So the syntax is data type variable name, data type and variable name is equals to in brackets data type and variable of another data type to which you have to convert that variable, right? So this is the basic syntax of typecasting you can use in your Java program. So here it is a chart that shows how typecasting is done in Java, right? So as you can see that in this chart you can go from you can see the arrows, right? So the meaning of the arrows is that you can grow from one point to the pointed arrow, but you cannot move backwards, right? So this is a main concept you have to understand in this chart, right? So this is a simple chart. You can go from byte to short, or short to int, or int to long, and then from char to int, and then long to double, and then from float to double, and from int to double, right? But you cannot go backwards, right? From int to char, or int to short, or double to int, right? It does not work backwards. So this is the specialty of the chart, and you have to remember this chart through the whole course, right? Because it is a very important concept in Java. You have to typecast a certain data types at certain point in every program so that you can get the desired output, and this is the main concept in Java. So I have generated this course to cover every single topic in the stipulated time, and I am doing my responsibilities very well, and I hope you will do not skip any lectures and just go through all the courses, right? So and keep practicing side by side. So let's stop for this lecture, and in the next lecture I will give you some examples on how to implement typecasting in your Java program.